kind of legend in my own mind. Thank you very much, Wayne. Always good to see Sam Silk here. Sam, thanks for coming in. Okay, well, talk about legendary dinosaurs right here at the Cleveland Museum of Natural History. Amazing. Now, not the dinosaurs we're used to that have been found in North America, but we're going to the other side of the equator. So I'm learning a lot. I think everyone will. That's where Amanda comes in. And dun-dun-dun. So T-Rex is this quarterback, you know, of the North American dinosaurs.
Absolutely.
But T-Rex has a little competitor here. Well, little. No, not a little competitor. This is Gigantosaurus, right?
Yeah, or Giganotosaurus.
Giganotosaurus. I was like Gigantosaurus because gigantic.
It's gigantic,
right?
Yeah. Right. So for close to 100 years, T-Rex was thought to be the biggest meat-eating dinosaur around.
Mm-hmm.
Giganotosaurus was actually found in 1993. It's a relatively new dinosaur.
Wow.
And it actually would have been a little bit longer and a little bit heavier than T-Rex.
So bigger than T-Rex. Mm-hmm. He wasn't the biggest dinosaur roaming around, right?
Right.
So what are we seeing here back at the tail area?
So they would have had these long tails with all these bones that muscles would have attached to, which mm-hmm. would have made them very powerful runners.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's some of the hip bones. One of the things that really makes this dinosaur different from T-Rex is the arms.
Okay.
So T-Rex has really, really tiny arms that wouldn't have been used for really capturing or holding prey.
But look how big this guy's arms.
Giganotosaurus could have held and captured prey. They're still relatively small, but bigger than T-Rex's.
Mm-hmm.
And then the major difference between this guy and T-Rex is in the skull. So Giganotosaurus has a longer, kind of more fragile or thinner, more slender skull.
Really?
T-Rex had a much robust, shorter skull. So T-Rex was capable of biting down with enough force of crushing its prey,
mm-hmm.
and its teeth were adapted to crush through bone.
And then we're looking at this guy here. Was he more of a slasher?
He was more of a slasher and a slicer. So his teeth are much more like steak knives. So he wouldn't have been able to crush bone, but he would have had a really good bite for slashing.
Well, I tell you this, even though his head is a little bit smaller and he's not a crusher, I would still run.
I would.
About how fast do you think this guy would have been?
Well, because of the rest of his skeleton too being a little bit more slender than that of T-Rex, he probably would have been a little bit faster
than
T-Rex.
So bigger and faster than T-Rex.
Absolutely.
That's a scary guy. Okay, extended hours of the exhibit?
Yeah, so we're open over the holiday hours longer on Fridays, mm-hmm. and we open earlier on Sundays, and full details can be found on the website.
Awesome. Lots to learn here at the Ultimate Dinosaurs exhibit. I'm so glad I had my paleontologist extraordinaire right here from my Jurassic period. This is so cool. Thank you so much, Amanda. Appreciate you.
Thank you for coming.
Merry Christmas and happy holidays.
You too.
All right, we're going to go back to you guys in studio because I'm trying not to get eaten bigger than T-Rex dinosaur. Yeah.
I can't wait to bring company to that.
You know what?
That'd be nice.
Yes, everyone's going to love it. It's a great destination.
Yep.
Awesome. And then